seem straightforward enough. So, let's see. Maybe this will be a quick one, as opposed to the Laura grind. Or this might be as terrible. Only time will tell. The good thing is that we get to hear Judy talk a whole bunch, and everyone will love that. What's up, power? I tried to find a good Carol image, because it's like little girl witch, but there aren't any good Carol images, because the terrible character. But alas, I tried to find the one where she's holding a fork. I couldn't find that. That was the closest thing I could think of. Thank you, JP Flint. We get a bit of traffic from all these guys coming to. Good to see your family. But she's oblivious to it all. I guess the best image would be when Dr. Vare catches the missile, but that's more about Vare than Karoru. This is my dear sweet dad. Too bad he's the only one in the house who can't use magic. Grandpa complains a lot about him, but I love him so much. So yeah, you're a magic family that runs a magic emporium. And this dude busts in and traps your grandpa in a mirror. And I think he wants to become immortal or something, because he's close to death, or maybe. So he needs the magic, which ultimately transforms him into chaos. Sup, Iwins, thank you. And as a part of a defensive maneuver, Grandpa warps us all away from here. So most, if not all, of the game is just you getting the crew back together.
Just wait for us, Grandpa. I'll go find everybody to help get you out of that mirror.
A lot of Judy talking in this. And on the way, we meet Kurt, who's a former knight who's mapping out the Jade Forest. Because he's a former knight, he's like, I'll go with you. Because I ain't got nothing else going on. And this next section is just going to be a bunch of random wandering around. We just want to go north until we're out of this area. It seems like every time you move to a random location. As long as you keep moving north, you'll be fine. I don't fully understand. That's really bad. That's a bunch of enemies, isn't it? It's like three? We don't really have good AoE at this point. Please, don't get in my way. And we're off. I think those guys are like 5% chance of aggroing too. Birds are a bit higher. We don't have aura. to start off with, unlike in the Laura scenario, so more likely to get encounters with things that we normally wouldn't be. The goal is to pick up Aura at some point to reduce the number of encounters. This guy has got 3 LP, so you can usually kill him in one shot.
Thanks to Kurt, I was able to make it safely through the Jade Forest. But that bat thing, he must be servant spirit.
First run's always the best. Gold all the time. Never not gold. In this town, we learned something. I wasn't really paying attention. Some dude absconded with their daughter to marry against her will. Presumably. So we gotta go get the daughter back. Which has nothing to do with what we're actually doing, but they're taking care of my dad, so I guess we feel indebted to them or something. Plus, we're good people. How long? I'm coming for you, Mom. Split. So, this is the shore scenario of the bunch. So we'll get to first deltas in no time. Ox. There's a new mechanic in this scenario where we gotta talk to people to learn about where to go. Which is annoying. This dude's Armand, he absconded with her, and he calls us ugly or smelly or something, so we fight him. But apparently he has this summoner friend, who didn't appear in the cutscene, who summons a frog. Then the frog kills the summoner. It freaks Armand out, so he bounces out the joint. Fascinating stuff. And Armand's father trashes him, disowns him, and says Armand's gonna come with us now to redeem himself. And everything turned out just fine. We're pretty bummed out about that.
But how'd I end up stuck with Armand and the incantation back there? I didn't like the feel of that.
And Armand is going to be our reverse Delta user.
What was that anyway?
So, it's a good thing you came along. Whoops, didn't mean to do that. Find that. Smashing too hard. I guess we don't have that. Armand's kind of a douche, but he's cool. Just gotta get to know him. More importantly, he has 21 LP. And growth rate of 5. For both strength and skill, which is the highest you can have. Whereas Francis only had 4 and 4 for strength and skill growth rate. And only 19 LP, so... Armand is better than Francis in every way. And this bat is trying to kill us because it's the Duder's familiar that attacked our grandpa. Oops, I forgot we shot. Well, hopefully this kills anyway. Come on. Don't make me a fool. Not even close, jeez. Okay, maybe it's not so bad then. Just pretend that didn't happen. But then there's more of them. So Dad sacrifices himself so that we can cross the bridge safely. I'm not sure if he meant to sacrifice himself, because he just kind of falls here. We'll see him later, though. It's all good. And shock will be our AoE attack until we get random arrow shot. We don't want to use shock too much because the bracelet we are using to cast it with has a pretty low endurance left, so it can break if we use it too much. That guy's still alive. And we need it for one spell during the chaos fight, so we don't want to break it before that happens. So that would be bad.
Being separated from my dad made me sad. I must have looked pretty miserable. Kurt tried so hard to cheer me up, and even Armand was a little...
Even Armand.
Besides, I can't afford to waste my time being miserable. I need to hurry up and find everybody so we can save Grandpa. It's all right. I know...
Just keeps on talking.
I'm sure I will.
And suddenly there are bandits attacking the town. We'll learn about that later, though. For now, we gotta kill them all. These are weaker than the versions we fight in a Laura scenario. They only have one LP, so it doesn't take too much to kill him. It's fortunate because you fight like a bunch at a time. So it'd suck if they lasted a while. And one more group, and then we'll be done here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6? I think there's 6. Give him the stab, and we're good. And then we see our brother running away with the bandits. We're like, nah, that couldn't be possible. But it was definitely him. That's not gonna last. Scale. And there are actually the same amount of scenarios in this character scenario. Adventure, let's call them adventures. In this character scenario than Loras, but they're all really short, so. Including the final dungeon's way shorter than Loras, which is crazy long. Because because we're already at the end of this one. So, brother joined the bandits. The Bandit King got killed because he had honor. Because they're secretly being controlled by this dark mage. Something like that.
I'm not fat. I'm just lovably plump. You blind?
Give him the slashes. But we still need one more wood, one more light, and a serpentine.
Oh, I wish.
And now the brother joins.
Pig. It's embarrassing. But then again, I shouldn't worry about it. A brother is still a brother, no matter how fat he gets.
True words, never spoken.
Started all this creepy craft. What on earth is going on? There seem to be some secrets hidden in the world of magic that I don't know about.
That's too expensive. Too rich for my blood. Whoa! That didn't kill any of them. Thank you. I'm pretty lucky with the encounters. Friggin' Vegiblast attacked me. Not getting a whole lot of the martial arts panels for old Armand there. Capper, I have to do. Red axe. Ooh, it's really rich for my blood. Suspenders. And we're on the ship. It's a familiar ship. And familiar sound. Less enemies in this version of the ship, though. Which is thankful. It does look like a pattern in battle, but it's obvious when you see the actual portrait. This dude just joins us for no reason, and we're okay with that. But this time we go up instead of down. Exciting stuff. Oop. So yeah, we use up the one knife until it's gone and then we switch to the other one. It always wears out around now, so that's why you forge the copper knife there. Hopefully the copper knife holds out for the rest of the game. Now it's time to fight giant enemy crab. And even though Judy is always at the front and she only has 10 LP, it's not actually a huge danger. She's rarely ever going to actually die because of that, because there's never any that many enemies in a single adventure. Yeah, she got a lot of duders around her. Which is good, because this game is sexist and gives a lot more LP to male characters than female characters. Which will be a problem with Myth's scenario, because Myth only has girls around her. Him, rather. So Myth is the only person with LP in Myth's scenario. Which will be fun. Finally, some friggin' fricks. Overall gain. And we're back in Vaftum. Every scenario goes here and enjoys the festival, so you always get a cutscene like this. And usually, one of the characters will interact with another. In this case, we interact with Armic. Because Laura and Henri were kind of dual protagonists in Laura's scenario, they just kind of hung out with each other. She just decides to join the parade. Doesn't even have a permit.
The town used to be lively, but now it's so quiet.
And in this scenario, you don't have a lot of money to work with, so you kind of can only splurge so much. And because I bought that lead axe, I basically have no extra money for anything else. That lead axe was too good. Three abilities on a lead item. Granted, you only need two abilities on a lead item, because you're guaranteed to get multi-shot in the second slot anyways. But there's no guarantee we'd see a lead item again, so I stand by it.
That Rebecca, where did she end up?
This dude just wants to find Rebecca, who's the most powerful of us all in terms of magic. Because he wants the forbidden magic or something. And our sister has been staying in this town, so we recruit her now.
My sister.
And we show her this creepy tablet we found earlier. She wants to investigate some more, so we go back to where we found it. And it's a special scenario where you have 100 turns to do this stuff. Otherwise, you fail the mission. But failing the mission progresses the storyline, so we're just going to wait in one spot for 100 turns. So prepare for some excitement. So there's been a debate about Turbo recently, which I really don't care about. But this could be an argument for Turbo. This is some real repetitive action. And we did it.
In the end, I didn't get to find out the secret of the magic tablet. If Grandpa or Mom were here, maybe they'd know. Okay, I'd better get going to find Mom.
Actually, we should have grabbed, whatever. Hopefully we'll have time to correct that mistake. Yeah, it's better. Probably didn't want to do that in actuality. Now the final section is looking for Mom, because we got the rest of the fam back together. It's a multi-parter though. Right in the gut. All right, this is the last shock we can do. I'm assuming weapon blessing only costs one. Didn't even kill him. I try not to think about too much of anything in this game, but I'll pay attention to the spikes now. I didn't even realize there were spikes. I think I went the wrong way here. SE. Nope. I guess that's supposed to be. Oh, wait, I think I'm back on track. Okay. Lost my spot in my notes. Oh, God. A lot of good laughing in this game. Oh no. Got attacked by a bird, dude.
Oh, I know this one well. This name, escapes me.
So can't afford to use shock, so. So I have to stab him individually. Sure. All right, this is the big section. Spear, wood. Bestial staff. Feather amulet. Bestial staff. Seven, it's no good. Copper knife, silver circos. Kappa sword, serpentine. Bad axe, serpentine. Bestial armlet. Okay. That was no K section. So, you'll get the metal bow with nothing. The bestial dagger with nothing. Staff, steel axe. No, that's not what we want to do. And body, velvet. All right. Is way better than Shock. I was not doing the right thing for Shock. Supposed to give Kurt more metal power so that it would actually do more damage, but it's hard to do. I just focused on skill. I figured it wouldn't be a big deal, but apparently it kind of is. If you want to go super fast. So, good for next time. I gotta learn the elemental Lee Strong panels, which I'll have to learn anyways, probably. Imagine some of the other scenarios rely on that.
Oh, I know this one well. His name escapes me at the moment.
And we're using a bunch of people in battle just because every time they use an action in battle, their max HP increases at the end of the scenario. We're trying to buff them up as much as possible. Didn't expect him to survive that. There we go. It's weird. Mary's hair in cutscenes is like red, but in the portrait there it's white. Really makes you think. And good use of the random arrow shot, though. Plenty of group encounters. And Mary and other dude we're not going to be using for the chaos fight, so there's no point in trying to buff them up. Alright. That's perfect. We got everything we need now. Assuming I didn't mess up, anyway. We don't have, like, the best possible equipment, but we have the best that we could hope for at this point. We're back in Escada. And we're like, why is it all burned down? Not that we're gonna do anything about it. So this will be the adventure that we spark reverse Delta on, hopefully. There's a chance we won't, then we'll have to get it later. But ideally, we get it here. So this is where Unlimited Saga begins for this scenario. Idea what that means. You eat all your opponents? Is he a cannibal? Not that we fight many humans, just the bandits that he was a part of, so probably didn't eat them. I guess there are a couple weird magicians that we killed. Freaking demons, they're everywhere. They haunt me.
The more they fight, the better they taste going down.
Is that Fry? Probably not. Kinda sounds like Fry though. She's out of commish. Thank you. Ow, hey, I stepped on this floor. Hopefully she is back in command. I guess we don't really use her, but she does take up a spot. Guess I could swap her out, but that'd be annoying. Just hope she wakes up in time. You can do it, Judy. Alright, so this is the reverse Delta fight of this scenario. The one where we learn it, hopefully. It only has 10 LP, so there's a chance we'll kill it before we learn it.
Judy.
Okay.
I never pretend.
I guess she's not even in the front row. So it doesn't matter. Except it does. Even though she's not in the front row, we have to rescue her or something? This is really weird. Come down. Alright, so I guess we do have to rescue her. She's conveniently off-screen there, I guess. Not confused or something, is he? So, no reverse Delta yet. We can learn it later, it's no huge deal. We still got some time left on this fight. Really does not like Armand. Which makes sense, he's in the front row. No mystery there. Alright, one last spurt. Alright, no reverse Delta this fight.
Thank you.
Alright, final scenario time.
I had hoped I wouldn't have to go this far, but I'm running.
And no one makes their first jump. So I don't have that much hope of finishing, but we'll get a shot on net, you know? Get this creepy animation of Judy here. But oh no, the bat broke the mirror that Grandpa was trapped in. So we're gonna have to go into the mirror in the sky to save him, I guess. Alright, here we go. Into the mirror dimension. So this area works in a weird way. You gotta pick up these parchments. But they're in random locations on each floor, and there's one per floor. We kinda gotta go to every potential location there is. And pick up the papers. Because they can only appear in certain spots. At the same time, every so often, there will be a red encounter, or birds of heaven will try to kill me. But as long as I get a green circle, well, I'll be good. So it's in the first possible location it could be, which is good. Now we can head straight to the exit. That's the bird fight. Basically, you just want to mash on that reel, and most likely you'll avoid the encounter. Probably messed that up. Oh, definitely messed that up. We'll pretend that didn't happen. Alright, fur. We can totally use that now. Bringing encounters everywhere. This knife is gonna wear out. Not that it really matters. Actually, no, this knife shouldn't wear out. We have a new one, that's right. Okay, not here.
What was this? I can't remember.
Alright, it's here. We can head to the exit of this floor. Alright, third floor. This is where the treasure force is, our save point. Not that we're gonna use it, because we're tryhards. And then there's one more floor after this, and that's the final bosses. So not quite as daunting as the Laura dungeon. And it's here. Increasingly convinced that that's just Fry. He really let himself go. I got our parchment. Oh! We're gonna have to fight a bird. These fights also double as a way to get reverse delta, because they have a high spark rank. But we really don't want to learn it, apparently. Thank you. Imagine if we could learn Reverse Delta. How powerful we would be. I actually don't know what the durability on that axe is like. Hopefully we're not in for a rude awakening. Probably could have, yeah, that wasn't the right decision. Zero sum. All right, one more floor to go. This one's a bit shorter, potentially. As long as it's in one of the first locations you're looking. Oh god! It's a treasure monster! Okay, that's plenty of endurance. Alright, that's it. Time for the final bosses. So the first boss is Clyde Blackstorm, the scenario-specific boss. He has 13 LP, so he doesn't take too much to kill. We want to get Reverse Delta on this guy. We don't want to be trying to spark it on Chaos. Because that's always fun. And we also want to use Bone Crusher once on him so that we can spark one of the useless abilities away. So that we can guarantee that we use Bone Crusher on Chaos. This section where I don't remember if I equipped everyone properly. I did not. Yeah. So we're no Bone Crusher. That's fine. Everything's fine. I forgot to give him the thing with the staff. Is 44 plenty? Yeah, probably. Oh my god, just Reverse Delta. This is new. Going into Chaos without Reverse Delta would be fun. We are all types of screwed. We don't have Bone Crusher. Don't have Reverse Delta. End me. And he's probably taking enough damage to be below half LP. Bad. Yeah, definitely. Oh my god. The run ends, not with a bang, but a whimper. Nice block. He's probably going to be below half LP now. Because why not? How are you doing? Yeah, he's not even going to be at full LP for the next fight. Finally! Jesus Christ. We're already screwed, but at least we have reverse delta. Because you only recover half your LP for the chaos fight, so if you're below half LP, then you're not going to be at full. Alright, well, here we go. Time to die a horrible, horrible death. But maybe we'll make it through. In my hand. You know, first run. Don't expect to get through it, you know? You know? Let's give the old college try. What's up, Clyde? Just in time. This will be a reference point for how not to fight chaos, probably. It's time to get serious. At least we have reverse delta. Guess we could try to spark drag down. No, we don't even have a... No, we can't. There's nothing doing on that front. Alright, no strength down on chaos. It's fine. Okay, at least he's at full.
didn't spell.
Ooh, I thought he was out. Whoops-a-daisy.
Aren't the Seven Wonders the symbol of our hopes and dreams?
Leave her alone. Okay.
Even the strongest magic in the world can't bring happiness.
Really makes you think. Alright, she's out. Sebadoo! Really makes you think. Still bad. At least we got Shadow Arrow out of it. Block. All right, here we go. Right, he doesn't have build up either. Alright, you're good again anyway. Yeah. Can do that in fourth phase. Feng Shui. Yeah, you're still best to send out. Crap. And into the danger zone with everybody. Might be death for someone. Everyone's still alive. Might be death for him. Nope, not yet. Might be death for him this time for reals. Yeah. Rah! What the hell? First try. Don't even care. I didn't even fight Chaos during my practice. I was like, nah, man. First time I fight him was gonna be during the run. I think I just got insanely lucky there, but I'll take it. And Clyde is now dead, I guess. Alright, so next is Ventus. I thought I'd have to grind it out at least during the week, but this isn't the best Judy run, not even close.
Hi there, it's Judy.
But it is mine.
My family's back to life as usual, just as if nothing ever happened.
Get some sweet doodles apparently. I've never seen this. It's exciting.
Being chased by my wasn't losing any weight. I suspect he's been sneaking snacks on the side. My ever so popular
Thank you.
Sister still gets asked out, but she's gotten better at turning.
No one has seen this.
Even so, she still goes to Beckett's for tea. Dad hasn't changed a bit, but Grandpa has finally stopped picking on him.
This kid just keeps going.
Mom seems a little nicer than before. She and Dad are all lovey-dovey. She started magic training again, and she's loving it. Grandpa was feeling down for a while. The stuff with Clyde was a big shock for him. But he said he was starting some research on magic tablets. He said he's got to do it for Clyde, too.
Farewell, Judy. We hardly knew ye. We'll see you again in April.
Of course, there's more to the story, but I'll stop here. Hey, a girl's gotta have her secrets. Well, that's it for my story.
That's it for her story. The hair pillow. Whoa. That's like junior high version. I don't know. It's weird seeing that art style on Judy. The end. Whoa. When I beat it with Laura, it said Finn. They're swishing it up on me. You have cleared two characters.